100%.
Yeah.
The Cleveland Browns are next up on our docket. They needed offensive line help. They needed linebacker help. They needed wide receiver help. And honestly, they did all of that other than wide receiver help, but I don't know really how much wide receiver help they really
needed. I don't know why they needed wide receivers. They have two elite wide receivers. Yeah. They don't have a huge depth chart of wide receivers, but they got two of the best 20 wide receivers in the league.
Per the Huddle report, their value grade was 7th in this draft, so right behind the Bengals.
Right behind the Bengals, that's right.
The only person that they took that was not a value pick per the Huddle report was linebacker Jacob Phillips out of LSU. Other than that, everybody else, offensive line, Jedrick Wills, they got him at 10. There was talk about Wills going number 4. KB jumped in and threw a poop icon to us. So, you know, the Brownies, of course. They got Grant Delpit in the 2nd round, way later than I thought anybody else would, which is.
The two safeties that fell were Delpit and McKenzie. And I couldn't understand it where DBs were going like crazy. I just think great safety play affects a defense way better than a cornerback does.
Yes. I mean, it depends on your scheme. They do so much more
than just lock down one side or one player. They affect the game, I think, from a big picture view than one cornerback. And cornerbacks just went like nuts. And these two safeties just fell and fell. In fact, I just couldn't believe it.
It was definitely strange. Delpit, you know, he didn't have a great last season. I think a lot of that had to do with the fact he was hurt for
the majority of the season.
Yeah, so of course he's not going to be as good as he was when he was a junior.
He never quit, and he still had a hell of a season.
When he got healthy towards the end of the year.
Oh yeah,
he looked lights out. So
watch the SEC title game. Watch the playoffs.
Yeah,
the three quote unquote biggest games of the year. Watch those three games.
That boy was on fire.
Elite competition. And as much as we like to crap on Oklahoma, offensively, they're elite competition. That's who Delpit went against, okay?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. They needed linebacker help. They got defensive lineman Jordan Elliott out of Missouri. There's a chance that he could end up being an edge rusher. It just depends what's going on. They got Jacob Phillips. We just talked about the sleeper for them that I really like.
I can't believe this dude went so late. I don't understand football.
Are you talking about Donovan Peoples-Jones?
Yeah.
Or
who you're talking about?
No. I was talking about Harrison Bryant, the tight end out of Florida Atlantic. Okay. That kid is legit. So they got him, I believe, 5th round. He is something else, man. They might have taken him. Was it 4th round or 5th? Yeah, 4th round. 4th round.
It was his second 4th round pick.
He was awesome at Florida Atlantic. He was absolutely awesome. I think he's got a real chance of making noise this year. He's not going to be, you know, offensive rookie of the year, anything like that. But I think he could end up being a starter in this league, and they got him in the 4th round.
So hold on. I want to remind people that I've been watching football for a long time, closely watching drafted players for a long time. Receivers, it used to be 3 years before they really broke out. Running backs, it used to be 1 or 2. Quarterbacks, it used to be 2 or 3. Tight end, and all of those have changed, by the way. All of those are guys that can come in the league and play right away, immediately. Yeah. Tight end is still a position that even the elitist of elite tight ends come in, and it takes them at least 2 years before they really find their footing. The difference between the game of football at the college level and the pro level for the tight end position is bigger than any position in the league.
Yeah, I could buy that.
So if this guy does nothing this year or next year, that does not mean a bust, okay?
Yeah, that doesn't mean he's not good. All that means
it just doesn't. I mean, look at the Broncos. Look at the two guys from Iowa last year, okay? One went to
Noah Fant and the guy that went to the Lions.
Not Husmanzada, right? What's his name, though? Something like that.
It wasn't Husmanzada. It was – I forget what it was. I'm looking it up now. I'm looking at it. Anyway, keep
both
going.
Both of those guys are going to be elite-level tight ends, I believe. And last year, they were okay. But they're rookies at the tight end position, and it's just a really big adjustment. Big, big, big adjustment. It takes 2 to 3 years to figure that thing out.
Yeah, it sure does. It sure does. But I do think – so going back to that, Harrison Bryant, I do think that he I think he has a good chance. Nick Harris out of Washington, interior offensive lineman. Good value pick. I mean, absolutely value pick. He was dominant for the Huskies. And then, of course, you take a flyer in the sixth round on Donovan Peoples-Jones.
This dude right here
was
given a third-round draft pick grade and coming out of high school, elite-level athlete, showed flashes and signs at Michigan. And I'm not for making excuses for these guys. I'm very much not. But I think the reason this kid fell and this kid didn't blow up the way some of these elite-level receivers blew up is, A, size-wise, 6'2", a little bit shorter than some of the elite guys out there. But the other thing is, at Michigan, they continually not just changed offensive coordinators. They completely changed in 3 years to three different offensive philosophies and systems.
Yeah.
And every year, even if they had the same OC from his first year to his second year, they still totally changed how they were going to play the game offensively. And then constant change at quarterback. I don't know how any receiver – this is exactly what I want with my seventh-round pick, by the way. This is exactly what I want. A guy that projects to be a stud, could be elite, that I'm getting this late. And guess what? If he's not elite, we're going to know in 2 years. Oh, yeah. We're going to put him on a bus and send him home, and he's not going to take up a roster spot anymore, and he's making the league minimum because he was a seventh-round pick.
Yeah, you're 100%
right. Exactly what you want late in the draft. I don't know why these teams continually draft players at other positions that you just know you probably could have picked those guys up in free agency or whatever. You ain't getting him in free agency.
No. I don't believe so. Back to the tight ends. By the way, T.J. Hockenson was the guy that went to Lions.
I knew it was a long H name. That was weird.
Let me get caught up in some of these chat messages here. Chris Gray's jumped in on Facebook. First time I've seen him on there. They showed us that UFO footage a few years ago. Now it was leaked, but it was not confirmed by the Pentagon. Confirmed.
The UFO stuff is confirmed now.
He said there's a reason why they brought it back up. Get your popcorn ready. Yeah, I'd love to see it. I'd love to see something interesting pop up. McKinnon jumped in. He said, Chris is 100% right. Next year, middle linebackers, safeties tend to be leaders on D, not to mention they typically have much longer successful careers compared to corners. Great examples like Ed Reed, Brian Dawkins, Troy Polamalu last forever, and they wrecked offenses. 100%. Michael,
the Honey Badger went to one of the worst defenses in all of football. Other than that, they didn't really lose a lot or change a lot. D Ford got out of there, but they didn't replace him with anybody special.
Yeah.
And he didn't make that defense elite, but he made just enough big plays to slow teams down, to get them to punt instead of getting an extra first down. I just don't understand why the league is just gone just cornerback crazy and safeties are falling by the wayside, man.
Yeah. Oh, it's crazy. Michael Fritch on Twitch said Fant got banged up but had a pretty good season for a rookie. McKinnon jumped in and said, did Moss Jr. ever get picked up? And then Just Say No to Drugs on Twitch, another new follower, said Thad Moss went to the Redskins. So, yeah, he got picked up as an undrafted free agent.
I wanted to get drafted so bad.
As far as the Browns go, like, dislike, I'll tell you mine. I like what they did.
Yeah.
I thought it was pretty good.
I did too.